Hello and welcome to this session. I'm Raghav and today we will learn how to use Katalon Studio Jenkins plugin. So there is a new Jenkins plugin for Katalon Studio and this will be very useful when you are running your test from Jenkins on Jenkins server or on a Linux system. And we will go very basic step by step and see how to install Katalon Studio Jenkins plugin, how to add the plugin in the add build step in your Jenkins job, how to add post build action to publish your Katalon Studio JUnit reports, and we will also look at a plugin called Test Analyzer plugin that will help us to create some really good graphical reports from our Katalon Studio results. So these are the references or these are the links for this plugin. Let me first take you to the links and then I will show you step by step how this is done. This is another link of Jenkins wiki page which shows us a similar documentation. So let us go here and you can see this is the Jenkins wiki page for Katalon Studio plugin and it says this plugin helps to download, deploy and execute Katalon Studio on Jenkins server automatically. So even if you do not have Katalon Studio already installed, it will help to download and even deploy Katalon Studio and then execute your Katalon Studio tests. And here are some usage and steps. This will be very useful. You can see this and this is another documentation and this is similar documentation with similar steps and these links are available here. All these notes will be available in the description section of this video. So now let's get started and the step one is install Katalon Studio Jenkins plugin. So I'm on my Windows system and I already have started my Jenkins here on port 9191. Just in case you have not watched the earlier videos on Katalon Studio with Jenkins, you can go to my website which is automationstepbystep.com and I will also provide the link in the notes. So you can go here and this is automationstepbystep.com. And here you will find online courses link. You can go to this link, online courses, and here you will find all these videos. So you can go to Katalon Studio and these are the all the videos you will find here, the earlier videos, and also we have a API testing with Katalon Studio series. So you will find all this here. So this is the entire playlist where you can find all the earlier videos just in case you have not watched how to set up Jenkins with Katalon Studio. In my case, I have already started it, so I will directly go to Jenkins on my browser. So I will say localhost and I have started it on server 9191. So I'll go here and log into Jenkins. And here I can start creating a new project or a new job. So I will click on new item and I can give it any name. I will say this is Katalon test demo and make it a freestyle project and say okay. And you can see here we can create our job or we can add our Katalon Studio commands. So you have seen earlier we used to go to build step and we will say add Windows batch command in case of Windows system, or in case of Linux or Mac we will say execute shell and give the command that we get generated from Katalon Studio. So if you go to our Katalon Studio and I will take any example project. So this is a project that I have created for API testing and I have a test suite here, and if I have to generate a command for this test suite, I go to build CMD and I give all the options here and say generate command, and this command we used to give in our Jenkins, but now with this plugin we do not have to do that. So let us see what we can do now. I will go again to my Jenkins and here the first step is we have to get the Katalon Studio plugin. So we can go to Jenkins and go to manage Jenkins. I will first just apply and save this and go to Jenkins and I will go to manage Jenkins here, and inside manage Jenkins you will find manage plugins. So I will go here and I will go to the available section. And here I will search for Katalon and you can see we have this option Katalon Studio. So I will check this and say install without restart. So in case your Jenkins is asking for a restart, you can do that. In my case, I am just installing it without restart. And this is successful. So I will go back to my dashboard and go to my project, Katalon test demo, and go to configure. And now I will go to the build section, and here is the build section. And if I click on this drop down, I have this option, execute Katalon studio tests, and this option you will get only when you have installed the plugin. So I will go here, click on this option, and here you can see we have got all these details. We can add the details here. So the first thing is we have to say, do we need to download Katalon studio version? And if you click on this question mark here, you will get an example. So you can give any Katalon studio version that you want to run your test cases on. So for example, I will say 5.10.1. so in this case you do not have to worry about installing and setting up Katalon studio on the system or the server where Jenkins is. It will take care of download and deployment of Katalon studio. And just in case you want to use a pre-installed Katalon studio, in case it is already installed on your system and you want to use that, you can always give it here. So you can give the location like this, you can give the location of your Katalon studio on your system, and it will use that particular Katalon studio. And now here we have to give the command line arguments. So if you click on the question mark here, again you can see these are all the arguments that we get in our Katalon studio command that we can give here. So in my case, I will go to my Katalon studio, and for this test suite I will generate a command. So I will click on build cmd on the main toolbar and select the test suite that I want to run and provide all the options. And I will say, in my case, because this is an API test, so I'm not getting the option to select a browser. Otherwise you will get an option for selecting browser as well. And I will say generate command. And here I do not have to copy the entire command, I just need the options. So I will just take these options and copy this. So you can see this is the command I have. I am copying all the command line options and will go back to my Jenkins, and here I will provide, or I will just copy and paste these options. So you can see I have given a project path, I have given the test suite path and the execution profile, and the browser type is web service. The same you can see here. Also, if you read here, we do not need to give the run mode, it will be taken as console by default. And if we do not specify the project path, it will be taken from the current workspace directory. So if you do not give the project path, it will be taken from your jobs workspace. In my case, I have given this. So you can see every job has a default workspace, and you can also give your custom workspace. If you go to the general section and go to advanced, you can also provide a user custom workspace here. So that's all I have given here. And we have option for X11 display in case you are on Linux, and also for Linux we have this XVFP run configuration. So if you are on Linux, you can give all these options. And then I will apply and save, and I will say build now, and let us see what happens. And I will go to the console output, and you can see, so you can see it will first download and install Katalon studio. So you can see it is now, it has downloaded and it is installing the Katalon studio 5.10.1 as we have given the version in the plugin settings. And this step of downloading and setting up Katalon studio happens only once, the first time, and for the next iteration or the next run of this job, it will directly take it from here. So it will not always download it unless you give a version which is not already available on this system. So let us wait for this process to get completed, and once the setup is done, it will start our test cases. So you can see the message, Katalon Studio has been installed successfully, and now it is running our tests. And let us see the output. So it is running all our tests now, and yes, all this is working fine. And now it is ending the test suite. All these tests are done and we have got the success message. So I will go back to the project, and you can see the first run is here, and this was successful, and we were able to do these first two steps. Now we also need to get our reports in Jenkins. So if I go to my Katalon studio, and if I go to the reports folder, and here I go here, so let me just refresh. So you can see here I am getting all the reports generated. However, I want to get these reports into Jenkins. So if I go to the reports folder, I will say right click, open containing folder, and here I have my reports getting generated. So what I'm going to do is this Katalon Studio folder or my project folder, I want to copy it and I will go to my Jenkins and go to my job and go to configure, and I can actually provide the location of my JUnit. So if you see here, if you go to any of the test suite reports, for example here, we have this JUnit report, and this we can use to send the results or display the results on Jenkins. So we can either copy the location of this folder and provide it in post build actions. You have the option publish JUnit test result report. I can give the option or give the location here for the test reports XML files, or I can also go to my general section, go to advanced, and I will say use custom workspace, and I will just say this is the workspace I want to use. So I have given the location of my project, and now I can give a relative location of XML files here in publish JUnit test result report under post build actions. So I will say, now you see here inside this folder we have given until this location into our workspace. So if I go to my workspace, I have given this location until API Feb 2019. So if I go here again, I have given location until here. So after this, we have to go to reports folder, and under reports we have test suite 1, and then we have this, the folder that gets generated with a timestamp. So we do not know what will be the actual name of this. So what I will do is I will say here reports test suite 1, and then I will say star, because I do not know what will be the name, it will be randomly generated, and then I will again say star.xml. So what that means is we have to go to reports, then test suite 1, and then whatever latest folder we have, and then the XML report. So this is star.xml, and so here it is saying did not match, but let me just try this out. I will say apply and save, and I will say build now, and let us see what happens. If I go to the console output, you can see this time it is already using the installed Katalon Studio from here, and it is not deploying and setting up it again. It is now directly running our test cases, and let us see what happens. So this is running fine until now, and we will look at the reports. So this is done, and if I go back to the project, until now we have not got any report. Let me run this again. I will say build now, and let us look at the console output. So this is running fine, and this is done, and I will go back to the project again, and you can see now we have got this test result trend. So that means it is now getting the data from our JUnit reports, and it is giving us here. I can also go inside this, and you can see all these details. So you can see the details of test cases here, and you can see all the details here, and you can also go to history and check. So you can, you will find all the details here. So you can see from second run onwards we are getting the details here. So we are now getting the result into our Jenkins. Now we can also use this test analyzer plugin, which will help us to show the graphical reports on Jenkins. So if you go to this test analyzer plugin Jenkins, and I go to the images, so you can see you can create some graphical reports like this using this plugin. So you can go to your Jenkins and go to the dashboard and go to manage Jenkins. So go to manage Jenkins here, and here go to manage plugins and go to the available section. And here I will search for test results analyzer, and you will get this option here. So this is the test results analyzer plugin in Jenkins. I will check this and say install without restart so that I do not have to restart it. I will just try to install and use this plugin, and this is done. So this is successful. Now if I go back to my job, usually I do not have to do anything as I have my JUnit reports configured. So this plugin, test result analyzer plugin, works automatically when you have JUnit or test engine reports configured in your job. So in my case, I have JUnit reports, so it will take the reports and directly show the results from the next execution. Or you can also see it has already come here, so it has already taken it, the data from here. So you can see it has taken the data, and you can see the details here. It is showing us all the details of passed, failed and skipped. And you can always go here, you can also filter this, so you can always filter this out like this, and you will find all the details here. You can go here and check all the details of the passed and failed, and all these details are here. You can also download a CSV file. So if you want to download a CSV file, it will download a CSV file for the results. And also I have a separate video on this. So if you search for Jenkins test result analyzer plugin and yes, so you can see this is my video, tabular and graphical reports. I will also copy this link and make it available in the references so that you can just watch this if required to get the details about this plugin. Fine, so this is how you can use Katalon Studio Jenkins plugin. This will be very useful when you are running your test on Jenkins and on a separate Jenkins server which is available on a Linux system. So this will be very useful and will be a next step in your Katalon Studio testing. I hope this session was very useful for you. Thank you for watching.